Welcome to the part 2 of this tutorial. So now I'm going to show you how you can manage layout for iPhone and iPad using the same storyboard. And now I'm going to take help of screen view. So what you need to do is you need to add some few more controls so that your view gets scrollable in small screens. So I'm going to remove this height constant from there, and now I'm going to add bottom constant to 20. And now I'm going to copy this and add two more extra buttons. This is our login. Let's change to cancel. Yes, perfect. So now let's embed this view inside of scroll view. Embed in scroll view. Yeah. So now we need to give constants for the scroll view. Let's give all 0. Now you need to provide this. So since it's super view has been changed, now its super view is scroll view. Definitely it is going to lose some of the constants. So let's go and let's see what constant it lose. It lost top and bottom constant. So let's give top and bottom constant here. Remember, some of the constants may get lost when you change the view hierarchy. Now since you need to remind the scroll view width and height for a quick fix, so you are seeing here the auto layout error, but for the quick fix you may give this height width and height constant. Okay, now so what does it means is this is scroll view, so it has like four constants, and the scroll view content view has height constant, bottom constant, width constant, and all the constants that is eligible to determine its width and height. And now the scroll view can determine whether the view inside, whether the content view is larger than the view size or not. So now this is not a proper way. So now let's remove the width constant. Now what is this? Is you need equal widths according to scroll view in order to prevent scrolling in horizontal direction. So what is this equal width panel? Let's see here. But what is this? So it's for you. This is. Now I need to remove this constant height property also. So if I remove this constant height property, no, this view cannot determine its height. So now let's look at the constants. It has like top all four constants. It has all three constants, but it has not bottom constant. So this view can determine its height. So you have to give the bottom constant for this cancel button. After you give the bottom constant for this cancel button, now the view can determine its height. So let's recap. So here is a scroll view and here is a content view. So the content view has equal width to the super view and four constants towards the scroll view. Now, since it has the four constants, now if the content view increases, then and if it does not fit inside the scroll view, now the view gets scrolled. But if the view gets fits in the scroll view, then the scroll property is disabled. So in this way, you can design app for smaller devices in iPhone and for bigger devices in iPad. Now let's look at the demo. So let's go and let's run an iPad here too. Will this get scrollable or not? And then we will run the same project in small devices. Okay, so it is scrolling in horizontal direction, but not in particular direction. So let's fix that. How? Why it indicate equal with this scroll view? No, what is the width of the scroll view? Top. And let's remove this equal width constant and then let's add 0. So what went wrong? So it's okay, let's run it. So we missed this, the leading and trailing. Let's have 20 clicks here. Leading is supposed to trailing is supposed to. So here is the training space to super view 20 and the changes to 0. And now it should work fine. Now it's not useful horizontal. Yeah. And neither in vertical. But what let's see in the smaller device in iPhone 5. Now the view should scroll in iPhone 5. So please hold on for a second. Now the view will scroll, but why do it scroll? Because the view has been fitted in iPhone 5. So let's add some extra controls now. So do we have smaller devices now? So let's add one more button here. And then this Bottom space is increased to 20 px. Now let's run. I guess now we should not wait. But let's add one more. Now what you can do is you can add some extra spacing about. So if the bottom spacing is larger. 50. Now let's run. So since it cannot maintain the 50 px bottom constants, which is good. Look, it is good. But what you could do is you can add some controls at the bottom and then see. Now if you run this project in iPad, it should not scroll because it can fit all this scale, all the content view inside the scroll view. The content view height should be always greater than the scroll view height in order to be scrollable. Let's see my iPad. So this is what we find. As well as what you can do is you can give the same, you can apply same the first approach to create different spacing for iPhone and iPad. Thank you guys for watching. So this was one of the live coding, so I had some mistakes. Hope you understand. Thank you.